Black hole sun, won't you come? Wash away the rain. Black hole sun, won't you come? Won't you come? Won't you come?
Hey there, MHS, and welcome to the first Friday show of the new school year. I'm Azaria Richardson, and I'm your host for this edition of the show. For those that aren't familiar with the Friday Show, just about every week we will air a program including segments that highlight sports, clubs, or other student-driven activities. First up is a look at the last week's Battle of Broadway at Demaree Stadium.
Last week, the Pirate football team matched the Andrean 59ers in their home game season opener, traditionally known as the Battle of Broadway. As the anticipation for the game to begin set in, our cheerleaders, dancers, and band entertained the fans. As the game began, Andrean took an early advantage, making the score 0 for Merrillville and 7 for the 59ers. Some early jitters and negative plays unfortunately affected the Pirates' play on Friday night.
I say the turning point in the game was at the end here. When we had our little fumble on the punt return.
The biggest turning point was some of our special teams play. We had some bad snaps and just some negative plays that went backwards. Some guys that first time snapping on a Friday night, first time playing, and some of them I think let the moment get the most of them. But we built from it. We improved as the game went on, and obviously we'll build off that, going into next week against Penn.
Down but not out, the Pirates mounted some late scores in the second half. Though they were defeated by Andrean, the Pirates looked to improve upon their mistakes as they continued their season.
My biggest problem on the field today was really having enough time to throw the ball. But we're going to work and get better on it. It's just timing and practice. That's all it is.
During tonight's game, our line, we could have did a little better. And our receivers could have caught a little more, but other than that, I feel like we played good.
I think the biggest thing for us, just too many mental mistakes, missed assignments. Whether it was offense or defense, it was always, one or two guys that just weren't quite there with their responsibility. Football's an 11-person sport, and it takes everybody doing their job to make the offense, defense, or kicking games successful, and we just didn't quite do that.
With the enduring game out of the way, the Pirates now turn their focus to Penn and hope that you continue to support the team for what hopes to be a great season.
We can fix everything. Everybody's just got to be better. There were good things that happened, for every kid that was in there, but there were too many negative things that happened. So we just got to fix the negative plays and then we'll be okay.
One thing I think I could fix going into next week's game, really just keeping my team up, and when they make mistakes or when I make mistakes, we all stay up, keep ourselves composed. That's really it.
The biggest thing that we have going for us is we got great leadership, we got good kids. We'll respond. We got tough kids that'll do what they're supposed to. So, we've got kids that'll fight and strive to get better, and we'll come working hard starting Saturday morning.
Whether you were on the internet or watching television earlier in the week, you couldn't miss information about the solar eclipse. Considering the magnitude of the event, MHS made sure all students were able to participate.
Last Monday was a historical day for us Pirates as we witnessed a solar eclipse. Not only did students experience this phenomenon here at Merrillville High School, but Mr. Williams, the planetarium director at Pierce, was able to get the whole community involved.
I'm Mr. Williams. I'm the planetarium director for the Merrillville Schools. We're out here on the football field at Clifford Pierce Middle School to observe the solar eclipse on August 21st. We've set up a telescope and we're actually projecting the sun here on the screen. You can see some sunspots. We have some clouds, so it's not a real clear view. But we have set up three observation sessions here at Pierce, one for the public, one for Pierce students, and we're also doing a streaming of the eclipse on the internet. We also have eclipse viewers to let people see the sun safely by looking directly at it. And the last time we had a major eclipse like this here in Northwest Indiana was in 1994. So none of our students were born back when that occurred. And the next major eclipse like this won't be for seven more years in 2024. So this is really, for our students, a once-in-a-lifetime event because it hasn't occurred before in their lifetimes. And we're glad that we have been able to provide solar eclipse glasses for every Merrillville student.
Students at Merrillville High School were very excited to watch the eclipse.
Why I take these to my head? Oh, because look, I can see under it, right? And I ain't like all that, because if I look up and then I look under it, that means I can see the sun. And isn't it supposed to blind you? The camera right around here. So yeah, if I look up, it's going to blind me. So that's why I taped it to my face, so I wouldn't see anything except for the sun, so I wouldn't be blind. I'm scared of the solar eclipse. I think, like, we all going to die or something, you know what I'm saying? So I got to watch it.
So there are a lot of conspiracy theories out there, and I'm like, and most of them is like, because apparently Trump was born like on an eclipse and something, so this is gonna be like his downfall or something like that. And then there's like another one, it was like the world's gonna end, and then like this weird thing about like aliens and then lizard people. I have no idea. People on the internet are weird.
1979, the last full one. I think this is an awesome learning opportunity. Getting some pirate pride going on, getting everybody out here, and we're all excited, having fun.
It was actually quite nice and exciting to have this happen on my birthday. I found out about it last month, and it turned out to be like really exciting and more than I expected it to be. I thought it was going to be like a quick thing, but it lasted for a very long time. It was really nice.
Watching the solar eclipse and experience it, I mean, it was pretty cool. It sucked that we couldn't look at it with our eyes, but we'd get hurt. So I mean, but seeing the moon move in front of the sun, it was pretty awesome. I'm glad I could experience something like that.
I'm actually not taking my, I didn't take my kids out for the eclipse. I'm going to wait until it rains, and we're going to watch that natural phenomenon of precipitation. That's what I really shoot for, precipitation. So I was unsure there was an eclipse today. It was kind of cloudy, and I stayed inside all day. I heard something about vampires and darkness, and that just scares me.
Not only was viewing the eclipse an amazing experience for all, but it was also a great learning opportunity for students and a successful first school-wide activity. Signing off from PNN, I'm Julian Henderson.
While many enjoyed the summer relaxing, the MHS dance team put in some hard work at a team camp in preparation for their current season.
Over the summer, our very own Merrillville dance team participated in a Universal Dance Association camp. The camp lasted 4 days and 3 nights and consisted of various activities that had to be completed in those days, such as having to learn 3 challenging routines in different categories of A, B, and C.
My hardest routine was my Hip Hop 5, because that was the most like uplifting routine, fast moving, fast paced. So that was probably the most hardest routine I ever had. Like, I constantly had to work to get that.
My hardest routine at camp was probably my B routine, because like it had some technique in there that I really didn't know, and I had to pick up on it really fast.
The hardest routine for me was my B routine, because it was a lot of like jumping around and a lot of turns and stuff. And it was just hard like learning it within like an hour or 30 minutes and then having to perform it like the next day. It was just difficult.
Along with the routines that had to be learned, the girls faced other difficult parts of camp.
The most difficult part of camp was the second day, when we had to wake up super early and we had to learn 2 routines that day, and it was hard. We kind of fell off, but we got back on, so that was the most difficult part of camp.
Okay, the most difficult part of count was probably having to like wake up early and dance all day and learn three dances really fast, pick up really fast, and drill downs, wanting to like get a gold ribbon. That was really difficult for me.
The most difficult part of camp was having to like wake up at like 6 o'clock in the morning to go to breakfast and stuff. And like we'll be working now and like the whole day, like we're doing stuff, dancing and stuff like that. So it's like we barely get any rest because we go to sleep at like 11. We have to wake right back up. We would just be tired.
For some of the girls, they had a chance to experience camp last year and they have different memories of each camp.
How does this year compare to last year? I think some of my older girls were more accustomed to camp, so they were able to help my new members coming on and just doing everything that they needed to do. So I think this year, I think last year was a little bit better, but this year it was a little bit more disciplined as far as what to expect.
This year compared to last year was better. We did more team bonding stuff. It was fun. The music, the routines, it was all fun. They had some of our music that we liked, so it was fun.
Okay, I think this year compared to last year, because like this year was better. Like we got more awards and trophies and stuff like that. Last year was fun, but like this year, like everybody got along. It was just a good year.
At camp, there were different team bonding activities that took place. Some of the team had their different feelings on how camp will affect this season.
The part of camp that I think will help with this upcoming season is when we had to pick up on all three routines really fast, and all the team bonding little exercises we had at night really going to help us come together as a team.
The part of camp I think that will help with this year is the team bonding activities we did. Like, we'll have team buildings where we'll get with our team and stuff, and we'll just do stuff together, and that'll help with this year for everybody to become closer.
I do believe that camp bettered the team as a whole because it was a bonding experience as well. The girls worked together tirelessly and effortlessly to learn all of their routines, and they all came together in the end. So I think that, you know, they got the gist of it, and they're one now. My proudest moment for the girls at camp would be we got second place homeroom team trophy, which was better than last year, and they got the 110% award. We ended up with a trophy. We got a Gatorade package. We got a Gatorade cooler. So I'm very proud of that because I made them get up extra early in the morning. We were always at the first ones at the gym and didn't even know that we were going to get that award until the end. So that was my most proudest moment.
After receiving the spirit stick every night, the ladies take many fond memories of camp with them as they begin their new season. Signing off for PNN, I'm Azaria Richardson. Many students use the new school year to hang out with old friends or visit favorite teachers. But for the incoming freshmen, life at Merrillville High School is a brand new experience.
Class of 2021 has officially completed their first week of high school and is starting to adapt to their new surroundings. We caught up with a few freshmen as they reflected on their first week of high school. Many students have contrasting ideas between the difference of Merrillville High School and Pierce Middle School.
What's different completely from middle school and high school is you get a lot more freedom and you meet a lot of new people. The teachers aren't like so rough on you.
I think what's like different from the high school than the middle school is there's a lot more classes and like a variety of people to meet, and there's just a lot more freedom.
High school work is more competitive and harder than middle school.
What I would say is completely different between high school and middle school is the high school is way bigger and we actually get to carry our book bags to each classroom.
To some freshmen, size does matter since a lot of them reflect on getting lost during their first week of school.
I do have experience getting lost to my college and careers class because I go from like the freshman wing all the way to like, it's probably not that far, but like D hallway, you know, that's kind of.
No, because you could just look on the wall and see the letter of where your class gonna be at, so it's not hard to get lost.
I got lost because there's these really tall people. I got lost in the main building going to Spanish, and it was kind of crazy.
I got lost in the G building, and I was somewhere I didn't know.
Oh, yeah, I got lost about 5 times trying to go to that choir room. No.
What advice have I received from upperclassmen is that I need to, like, be nicer and respect, like, the teachers, like, some of the teachers that I have.
Some advice I got from some upperclassmen is to mind your own business and do your work and, like, just do you.
Yeah, the upperclassmen have given us the advice that focus on your grades and your classes and, like, don't focus on drama or that. Focus on sports, extracurriculars, just the things that matter.
Advice that I've received from upperclassmen is to just do your work and be prepared for class and stuff like that. And don't be lacking your freshman year.
Get involved, keep your circle small, and don't trust everything you see or hear, and be careful with those boys.
One goal I have for my freshman year of high school is to do good academically and do good sports-wise, like with my sports. I plan to do this by studying and paying attention in class and working hard out of school and practice and doing what I have to do.
My goal for my freshman year is to pass all my classes with at least a B and an A, keep my GPA up, and basically meet new people, really.
My goal for the end of freshman year is to pass all my classes with all A's, like make the honor roll, and focus on sports and that, make all the sports team I want to, be on JV, varsity.
1 week down, 3 years and 60 plus days to go. Freshmen, may the odds ever be in your favor. Good luck. Signing off from PNN, I'm Imani Butts.
This weekend, the world of boxing and mixed martial arts meet up in a sporting extravaganza as Floyd Mayweather and Conor McGregor meet in a highly anticipated fight that many will be watching and debating.
It's Maxwell on the beat.
This Saturday, August 26th, we have the chance to witness the fight of a century. Undefeated professional boxer Floyd Money Mayweather will take on UFC champ, the notorious Conor McGregor, in a 12-round dream fight in Las Vegas. Many students and staff members here at MHS have been discussing the fight since the year began, and many have their opinions on what will happen.
I like to think that McGregor will win the fight just because he may bring something different to the ring than what Mayweather may be expecting because he used to boxing with boxing.
Okay, now Floyd Mayweather, he's been in boxing for a while, so I think he'll do pretty good at beating this McGregor guy. But at the same time, McGregor gonna give him a run for his money.
All right, Money Mayweather's gonna win because he's undefeated. He's a great athlete, he's a madman, and I feel like he'll just adjust and adapt.
Well, I definitely know that Mayweather is going to win the fight simply because he may be the greatest boxer of all time. Conor McGregor is one of the best mixed martial arts fighters. However, it's two totally different sports, two totally different disciplines. I think Conor will stick in there and defend pretty well, but I look for Mayweather to probably pick him apart on a decision.
Okay, to be honest, I want Conor McGregor to win, but I feel like Mayweather going to win because, you know, they in his home turf. If they were doing a UFC fight, then McGregor definitely win.
While many seem to think that Floyd will come out victorious, the debate rages on over how long it will last and how it will end.
I think it's going to go about 10 rounds. Why? Because it's a money thing.
Only three. Because Mayweather, he don't play around. I think he's going to knock McGregor out.
I think it's going to go 12 rounds, and if it go to decision, nobody loses in a decision with Money Mayweather. So if he want to win this fight, he needs to go ahead and knock Mayweather out.
While the smart money would definitely be on Mayweather with his 49-0 record, McGregor's knockout power still poses a threat. Tune in this Saturday night on pay-per-view to see if McGregor can make history. Signing off for PNN, I'm Jasmine Martinez.
Thanks for watching today, and tune in next week for a brand new edition of The Friday Show. As we leave you today, we will air a couple of music videos from our third trimester students from last year. Signing off for PNN, I'm Wazaria Richardson. And have a great weekend, MHS.
Dear Diary, I met a boy today. He said his name is Raymond, but his friends call him Ray. Really cute, nice swag, kinda tall. He told me daddy who, but he don't look like he play ball. He asked me for my number, I said no. My parents real strict and I'm for sure they ain't gon' go. I'm thinking, man, all the girls like him. So I tell him, we can chat, hit me up on AII. Through the door. I know you ain't gon' like this, but I met a boy named Ray. He's never disrespected me, he's very smart in school. I don't know, it's something about this boy reminds me of you. Daddy, wait, I got a confession to make. I know you ain't gon' like this, but I met a boy named Ray. He's never disrespected me, he's very smart in school. I don't know, it's something about this boy reminds me of you. I like you.
Time. what I promised her that night. Cross my heart and hope to die. Stabbing me apart, she's slipping away. Am I just hanging on to all the words she used to say? The picture's on her phone, she's not coming home.
I'm not coming home.
Oh, nah, 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 oh, yeah. I know what you did last summer. Just lie to me, there's no other. Can't seem to let you go, can't seem to keep it close.
Only close.
I can't seem to let you go, can't seem to keep you close.
You know I didn't mean it though.
Tell me where you've been lately, tell me where you've been lately.
Just hold me close.
Tell me where you've been lately, tell me where you've been lately.
Don't let me go.
Can't seem to keep it close, can't seem to let you go.
I didn't mean it though.
I know you didn't mean it though, I know you didn't mean it though.
I don't wanna let you go.
Tell me you didn't mean it
no,
though,
no,
tell
no.
me you didn't mean it though.
Can't seem to let you go.
I know you didn't mean it though. I wanna know you mean it though. I know you didn't mean it though. I know you didn't mean it though. I can't seem to let you go. Can't seem to hold you down. I know what you did last summer. Just lie to me, there's no other.
Whether you were on the internet or watching television earlier in the week, you couldn't miss information about the solar eclipse, considering the magnitude of the event. While many enjoyed the summer relaxing, the MHS dance team put in some hard work at team camp in Port That was funny. Okay, I got it. And the sporting extravaganza. This weekend, the world of boxing and mixed martial arts meet up in a sporting extravaganza. As Floyd Mayweather...